your science buddy Arohi. I'm sure you must have come across the term climate change several times on television, in newspapers, on various social media platforms, whether or not you follow the politics behind it.
Climate change is not science fiction.
Climate change is real.
Climate change for me is to the planet what the chronic diseases of our times are to our human body.
Climate change is happening here and now.
The threat of global warming challenges us to build green communities.
We will condemn our children to a planet beyond their capacity to repair.
So everyone seems to be talking about climate change, and everyone seems to be suggesting that we are in some way or the other responsible for this climate change. Well, that's true, my friends. Climate change in fact affects all our lives. Let's try and understand the science of climate change and how we contribute to this global issue. I will try to keep the science simple, because if science is not your cup of tea, here comes your bowl of sciencey soup. Till now, life has been possible only on our planet Earth because of its climate, and this climate is maintained by greenhouse gases. So what are greenhouse gases? To explain the concept of greenhouse gases, I will give you a very common example. I call it
car under the sun example. In our day-to-day life, all of us must have experienced this. If you park your car under direct sunlight, the inside of the car gets hotter than outside. That is because
sun's rays pass through the car's windshield and window glasses. The interior of the car re-radiates this energy in the form of heat radiations called the infrared radiations, which cannot pass through glass. The sun's heat can come in but cannot go out. The heat accumulates, and this makes it really hot inside the car. Now the same concept is used in a greenhouse in a nursery. A greenhouse is essentially a house made up of glass and is used to grow plants at a controlled temperature. It looks just like this one. The glass roof and walls of a greenhouse allow sun rays to enter inside. The infrared radiations emitted from the interior of a greenhouse cannot pass through glass. The trapped heat energy keeps the temperature warm inside and allows a favorable growth of the plants. Similar to the glass roof and walls of a greenhouse, our Earth's atmosphere has a warming effect that makes life possible on Earth. This property of the Earth's atmosphere is because of some specialized gases called the greenhouse gases, which include water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, ozone, CFCs, HFCs, and many more. When the sun's rays fall on the Earth, a part of them is reflected back by the Earth's atmosphere. A part of these rays is reflected by the Earth's land and water surfaces. And a small portion of these rays that is infiltrated through the atmosphere is absorbed by the Earth's surface and is re-emitted in the form of infrared radiations, which we feel as heat. Some of these radiations escape into the space, while some are trapped into the atmosphere by the greenhouse gases. Thus, the heat trapped by the greenhouse gases keeps the planet warm. For the temperature of the Earth to remain constant over time, the solar energy absorbed by the Earth's surface and the rate at which infrared radiations are lost into the space must be in a perfect balance. Climate scientists have proven that the amount of greenhouse gases has increased over the past century, and what the Earth is facing today is an enhanced greenhouse gas effect. As a result of this, lesser radiations are being emitted into the space because more and more infrared radiations are being reabsorbed into the atmosphere and are being re-emitted to the Earth's surface. Thus, an excessive amount of heat is currently being trapped by the greenhouse gases, causing excessive warming, which we call as global warming.
If we have a very thin layer of greenhouse gases, our planet will become as cold as Mars, whereas if we have a very thick layer of greenhouse gases, it will become as hot as Venus. This is how the greenhouse gases maintain the climate of Earth.
Hey Arohi, please hold on, I have some questions.
Oh, Ankit, welcome to Sciencey Soup. Please have a seat and we'll discuss about your questions. So we have science buddy Ankit here on Sciencey Soup.
Hello everyone, and it's nice to be here. my first question is, if whatever you are saying is correct, we have greenhouse gases around the globe which is maintaining the temperature and climate of our planet Earth, then why the climate is changing?
Well, the climate is changing for sure, and this change is inevitable. The thickness of the layer of greenhouse gases that surrounds the globe has been changing throughout the history of Earth, and this has changed the climate of Earth several times, but this change has been at a very slow pace.
Our Earth has had an incredibly varying atmosphere ever since its existence, and accordingly we have had a series of short and long warming and cooling periods. But the temperatures that we are experiencing currently are much higher than the Earth has ever experienced before. For millenniums, atmospheric carbon dioxide had never been above 300 ppm before 1950s. In 2017, we breached the 410 ppm threshold for carbon dioxide. Since 1850s, the global average temperatures in relation to the average temperatures between the years 1961 and 1990 have been constantly increasing. In the past two decades, there has been a massive increase of 35% in the amount of greenhouse gas emissions.
Such a massive increase in just 20 years! I think it's really alarming.
Yes, it is.
So, what do you think? Why it's happening?
In 1800s, rapid industrialization occurred, and that resulted in a change in land usage at a very fast rate.
It was at this time that we first noticed a dramatic rise in the global emissions of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases. The global carbon dioxide emissions in early 1800s was 3 to 7 million tons per year. By 1850, it reached 54 million tons per year, and currently we are pumping out 40 billion tons of carbon dioxide per year into the atmosphere. Burning of fossil fuels, which include coal, petrol, diesel, and natural gases, is the chief contributor to the enhanced greenhouse gas emissions. Of the total greenhouse gas emissions, about 14% come from automobiles, about 21% from industries, and about 25% from electricity generation. It may be difficult to believe for some, but the everyday electrical appliances that we use are a major cause of global warming. As 57% of the electricity that is used to power these appliances is generated from fossil fuels. The waste that we are generating on a daily basis and its dumping at the landfill sites is another major accelerator of global warming. Every year, 1.3 billion tons of waste is getting dumped at the landfill sites where it gets decayed by the action of microorganisms. The process releases methane and carbon dioxide, both of which are the most devastating greenhouse gases. By cutting down trees, we have depleted the major carbon dioxide sinks of the earth. We have been cutting trees for urbanization, timber, industrialization, crop farming, and animal farming, all of which have accelerated global warming.
Oh, did you just say agriculture causes global warming?
Yes, you heard it right. With the increasing population, the global food requirement is increasing, and this has led to agricultural intensification.
According to the recent estimates of the US Environmental Protection Agency, 24% of the total annual greenhouse gas emissions come directly from agriculture, forestry, and other land use. 75% of deforestation in the developing countries is for agriculture. And guess what? 70% of the global agricultural emissions come from livestock farming. So if you are planning to have steak tonight, these overwhelming numbers may force you to rethink.
Okay, whatever you are saying is fine, but I still have a couple of questions.
Go on.
Yeah. So firstly, if global warming is really happening, then why we are getting extremely cold winters nowadays? And secondly, even why should I bother? Because winters are really very harsh in the region where I live, and I would be very happy if I get some warm weather during winters.
Yeah.
I don't see any issue in this.
So these are some very common questions that all of us get in our minds. And therefore, I'm going to discuss these in the next video of Sciencey Soup. And also, we'll be discussing how climate change is affecting us and what could we do to tackle this global issue. Till then, take care
and be curious.
Hello again. If you enjoyed this video, please like it, share it to your friends and family, and subscribe to our channel.
And we will keep bringing science to you in very simple language, because science really matters. And if science is not your cup of tea, here comes your bowl of sciencey soup.